Bardzo ładnie jest.
Tak. 3, 2, 1, let's do this. Hi, my name is Monika Cioch. On this channel, we talk about fragrances. So if you're interested in that topic, press that subscribe button and let's get on with today's video. Today we're talking about five of my most complimented perfumes fragrances of this year, 2019. So without further ado, let's start with the first fragrance. Emma S's fragrance, Barrow Street. It says New York makes me special, and this is the Eau de Toilette. This is quite a unique fragrance in my collection, and this is a Scandinavian fragrance from a Scandinavian skincare brand. And Emma S, who's the founder, she actually released two fragrances and a candle, and I love them all. The candle is amazing, and this fragrance I wore all summer long, and this really excels in the summer. This smells like fresh citrusy vetiver, so it's got mandarin, it's got some like a green apple smell, it also smells a bit spicy, like ginger, kind of pink pepper spicy, but it also has got the smoothness, which is a bit of a, like, almost like when apples are fully ripe and they don't have that acidity, like a biting acidity, they start being a bit lactic, but a bit soft, if you know what I mean. This has got that sort of smell. It's a very, very refreshing fragrance. It smells amazing in the summer with the body chemistry, and the quality of ingredients is very, very good. It smells very unique. I haven't met anybody who smells like this, because it's a Scandinavian fragrance that not many people know about, but because I used to live in Scandinavia, I discovered this. I'll link the website for this fragrance down in the description bar. It's just to make it easier for you to discover. I believe this is also a women's fragrance, but to be honest, I think a guy could wear it too. I got so many compliments from men and women both in the summertime, because this fragrance is, it just smells like summer and like a body odor type of smell, but in a really refreshing and really beautiful way. It's just really nice and pleasant to be around, so that I think that's why people really really liked it and really complimented me on this fragrance. Emma S, Barrow Street. New York makes me feel special. Is Philosikos, and this is the Eau de Parfum version from Diptyque. Oh my gosh, I love this fragrance so much. And this is supposed to be a unisex, and I believe it is. It's a green fig scent with some coconutty type of notes in it too. So this is fresh figs, but a bit rounded by this lactic kind of coconutty smell. I wore so much of it. If you're listening to the podcast, I basically have nearly run out of like half of the bottle. I have sprayed so much this year. I got it last year for my birthday, and this has become my everyday sort of smell. It has become my signature smell. I really, really like the uniqueness of the notes. It's not the most projecting kind of smell, but whenever I have greeted somebody, or like, you know, did the three kisses, which you do in Europe when you greet somebody, people have really complimented me on this, especially guys. I don't know what it is about figs, but loads of guys seem to really like the smell of figs, and this is an excellent real fig scent. But I wouldn't recommend you guys go and get it. Definitely smell it first, try it on your skin, because it changes depending on the weather that you wear it in, which is really nice for me because it keeps things interesting. So, number four, Philosikos by Diptyque. Next up, we've got Kayak 10 by Labo. And this is a very true Kayak wood type of scent. It's a very simple scent. It smells like very dry wood. This is very, very difficult fragrance to describe because it's just so unique. It's simple yet complex. It's very light, but although it's elusive, I have gotten loads of compliments actually when wearing this. And I always wonder, how do people smell it? Because I stopped smelling it after about half an hour of wearing it. It's a very light scent, but somehow, even hours later, people actually notice it and I don't smell it. So it must mean that it's a very good, like, in-air kind of scent. And I think I have gotten loads of compliments on this one because it's unlike any fragrance I own. It's very rare. This is, I think it's a Tokyo special scent that you can only get in Tokyo. And also once a year in September, they do a city exclusive pack where you can sample all the city exclusives and buy them off the website, which is very good that they make it available like that. I just really, really, really love the scent and people do too. One of you have asked me because Labu says that their fragrances can only be kept for 12 months and then they go bad. I have had this for 2 years, and I have kept it in a dry, dark place and it's still perfectly fine. It hasn't changed. So I think it's more of like a marketing thing, and also because the fragrance has got a clear bottle, they think that maybe not everybody will think to keep it in a dark place because you can't expose fragrances to loads of light. So I think that might be why they recommend 12 month storage time. But don't worry, just keep it in a dark place and this is amazing. So Eric 10 from Le Labo is my next most complimented fragrance of 2019. Next up, we've got fragrance that I have just literally bought 3 months ago, but it has already gotten loads, like it has gone to my top list of most complimented fragrances, and this is 11th Hour by Byredo. This smells like spicy white wine, kind of mulled wine type of scent to me. This is Christmas, like a perfect Christmas scent for me. It's cozy, it's spicy. I think it's got some cloves in it, like cinnamon cloves, but still it's got this great sharp kind of fruity scent to it that kind of makes it, just breaks through that spiciness and makes it just the best scent ever. In Slavic countries, we drink this special kind of like a juice with our Christmas meal, but it's not a juice, it's like dried fruit and spices, and then you boil it and then you serve it cold with dinner, and this kind of smells like that. It's a beautiful type of scent. Again, I think the spiciness of this has made this give me as many compliments as I get with this one because it's so unique, it's so different, and people are like, what is the scent? What is the scent? They want to know, which is great if you like to wear fragrances that get you noticed. And this is again a unisex fragrance. So, Byredo, 11th Hour. And the last scent and the most complimented this year is press that thumbs up for this fragrance because it's truly special. It's Tom Ford Tobacco Vanille. I have worn this loads. This is, I think I have worn like nearly 3/4 of this fragrance this year with my husband because we both wear it. It's a unisex scent. It's just so wonderful. I love it so much. It's got my favorite notes in it. It's got tobacco and vanilla. It's a very cozy type of scent. I wear it with winter jumpers, with cashmere jumpers, with big, big coats and big kind of shawl scarves. I just love it and it makes me really happy. This fragrance is one of those fragrances that kind of smells like gingerbread to me too, like a Polish gingerbread. It's just really wonderful and whenever a fragrance makes you feel all those things, I think it does make others like really, really like the fragrance too. And I have gotten loads of compliments at work, just like walking around. This is a very strong scent too, so people really notice it. It is used quite a lot, people love it. And it's not as unique as some of the others, but I think this is a true perfume collection must. It is a crowd pleaser, but it's still got a touch of originality to it. It's one of my fragrances that I will repurchase again and again because it's that good, and my husband loves it too. So we both wear it and try to wear it loads in the winter time, so it reminds us of those winter moments and Christmas. I also wanted to ask you, which fragrances are your most complimented fragrances this year? I'll be doing a new video every single year just to keep track of what fragrances have gotten me the most compliments. And now it's time for the comment of the day. If you subscribe to this channel and press the notification bell and comment, I will read your comment. My favorite comment, it's from Tracy Norton. Hi Monica, I think you've got this review right on the money. This is one of my favorite fragrances. That person is talking about Allure Homme Porto Extreme. I can wear it anywhere and it smells fantastic, I do agree. I still have quite a bit left in the bottle because I have so many other fragrances I love, but one of my favorite for the summer. Good job. Thank you so much, Tracy. I loved reading your comment and I really do read all my comments and try to at least heart them all. And then sometimes I comment, well, most of the times I do try and comment because there's so many now of you that I just feel the love and I want to give back to you and I want to, you know, start conversations with you talk about fragrances because it's so nice to have this community of fragrance lovers. I post every Monday and Friday and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys!